Ah, another day of Rocket League means another day to experience the life of a Silver. We're currently at Silver 3 Division 3, in episode number 10 of the Supersonic Road to Supersonic Legends series. Hopefully we can get into gold in this episode, but as you guys saw in the last episode, we talked a lot about how to play that patience role and just sit in that midfield and scan the field to basically get an up on your opponents and get an easy advantage. So we're going to be using that once again as a strategy in this episode to try and move into upwards of Silver and also getting into gold. As I talked about, this will be an easy way to rank up and, you know, basically just have an advantage on your opponents. So we're going to search for a game here, jump right in, and hopefully we get a match quite soon. I mean, it's quite nice how fast you get a match here at this rank, despite, you know, it being a little bit later. But we got Turtles, and Kyle's mom and Donkey Punch. We got Turtles on our team. It's nice to be able to queue and just get an immediate match. It's really, really refreshing. You know, being in the top 50 of every rank, like, you kind of sit there for about 20 to 30 minutes. So, got our first game here. My teammate is telling me to take the shot when I'm on the closest kickoff. It's a classic. I see my teammate wants to come in, so I see that he's a little bit further behind. I'll get the mid boost instead. It's a good try on the shot. So once again, this guy should be faster than me if he was moving a little faster. He's pretty slow, but he would beat me there. So I'm going to be patient and just sit in the mid, wait for that bounce. My teammate is there to finish it. Nice. So what I did there was just wait for the opponent. Once again, playing that patience role, he hit it to me, which then lets me hit it forward. And now my teammate can come in and clean it up. I'll say a nice shot back to him. I didn't do too much. All I did was one touch, just followed on the wall, waited for him to hit it to me. And then, oh, he wants it. That's fine. A lot of people do left goes, but this is a pretty high ball. I'll try to just pick that a little bit. And it was a good shot from them. I don't want to hit those because they have a good chance on it, and it's pretty high. I think I ended up touching it in the back of my car, which is, you know, it's a good try. You don't want to try for the aerials, like I said. You'll want to beat that opponent to that ball. This is a pretty high ball. It'll be pretty dangerous. It's a good try from him. It's not going to be on target yet. I can wait for the bounce, then hit it. And you can see I'm just going to lead the ball here. My teammate's kind of right behind me, but I'll let the ball roll there. I'm doing a little bit too much once again, so move behind. Grab the mid boost. See if he wants to pass to me. So my teammate is rotating ball side here. So you want to just let him deal with the ball. And here we're just going to sit behind. Let the ball bounce once again. We can sit here and wait for this. They're both trying to chase it. But if I read that bounce way earlier than them, I'll be able to get ahead of the play. And he almost clears into his own net. Here, I'm going to wait here. It's a good beat. Could be a good try. See if a teammate can save it. Good try there. So I don't want to move too fast. Obviously, I could have just beat them there, but I wanted to give them a good try to push up on that. And they do get a clear over my head. There, like I said, that's another situation where if you play a little bit faster, a little bit quicker to that ball, you can easily pop it over their heads and get a shot on goal before they can do anything. So here, I'm just going to get a solid 50-50. Like I said, I'm not really trying to, like, you know, destroy the opponents in this series. It's more about teaching people what to do at a certain ranks. They're giving me some space here so I can let the ball bounce to me and then hit it. They're kind of not in net. So I tried to save that because that was a little bit too much. One hit. 50-50. Teammate is on the side here, so I'm going to sit in mid. Wait for this touch. Clears it across. You can see I'm trying to line it up with the touch. It's a good clear from the opponent. So the opponents are playing pretty fast here. Good save. So as you can see, though, the people are getting a little bit quicker. I keep forgetting not to just shoot those. That might just be in. That's my bad here. You can see how much space I have, though, just to launch that down the field off that half volley. And it wasn't that fast. I really didn't expect that guy to come up in midfield. It seemed like he was being a little more passive the rest of the times. And I keep forgetting to do that, to just not shoot on target. That's my big problem. I just keep shooting it right towards the net. If I'm going to hit it down the field, I can hit it hard down the field. Once again, this is pretty hard for someone to save at this rank, but if you just like roll underneath the ball like that, I think I'm just keeping the ball too close. Dude, clear across the side. Looks like Kyle's mom might beat me there, so I just waited, but he decided to just NASCAR all the way back home, which is fine. Donkey Punch once again should beat me here, but he's been moving really, really slow. I'm just gonna wait for him to touch it, and you see how he's passing it to me. Pass the middle. They're both overcommitted. Good shot. So I didn't do too much. I don't know why he's so excited about that. I just did a little pop off the wall, and he was up the wall trying to do what I was doing. Which, once again, I'm just finding the fact that he's trying to be on the ball all the time, Turtles, and I talked about this a lot. When you get a teammate like that, you have to try and lead him or her into a spot where they'll be able to follow the ball up and you're not overcommitting with them. Look at the back corner here. Good touch from Turtles. Good pop in mid. And a good finish. Just pick up the pace. It's a good shot. You know, we also saw our first taste of toxicity in the last episode, so I'm glad to see some more positivity on the team here. So it should be... Okay, he's sitting in net. So here I can grab the boost. Team wants to come in. So here I can let the ball do the work once again. Let the ball do the work to the corner. If he wants to rush it, that's okay. Not to do too much. Once again, just let them chase it down and then come in and chip it around. Donkey Punch is in a tough situation. Ends up leaving the ball too. He didn't know what to do. That's a situation where you can't let the ball do the work because the opponent is rushing up on you. Turtles sees that bounce and Donkey Punch is just rushing in from the side and not really covering the net. And Turtles is able to come in and sweep that. So we get the first forfeit, which should help quicken this road to Supersonic Legend. We're still in silver on episode number 10. So we got to get a few more wins per round here and hopefully move up a little bit faster. So we're still Division 3. We actually got carried by our teammate, which is perfect. That's what we want to do in this series. Up until later where we're going to have to do a little bit more work. But right now, it's good to just kind of take a chill pill for me and just, you know, talk about the best strategy to move through silver and also through gold and platinum. I would say all these things I've been talking about so far could be very, very much applicable to those ranks, even maybe diamond in certain cases. But with diamond players, I've noticed the mechanics are a little bit better and you start to see a little more crazy action going on. That might not be good for this pace, but as you pick up the pace, you still want to apply these concepts. We got Yaos Gamer or Yaos Gamer? I don't know. Yaos, something like that. We got Fat Moist Dudes V2. There's a second Fat Moist Dudes out there somewhere. Got a second account maybe. Oh, almost. Team is going to be coming in there. I could hear that Damon was coming in from the side. I'm going to loop around the side and go to the wall. I got bumped my teammate. All right, though. He's gonna chase it down. I'll let him come in and cut the ball. I see Demon as well. So I'm just waiting in mid. So I can pop out mid. Demon's kind of, you know, tough situation. Doesn't quite get the shot. And there's a finish. So it's a good play by my teammate. I just get a side flip into that. I was just trying to block the angles. My teammate passed it a little bit further behind than I expected to, but I can sit there and sort of bait in the opponents. They think I have possession, so they're going to try and barrel at me. So the best thing there is to just stay grounded and get a good 50-50. Obviously, they didn't even hit the ball, so it just went towards their net, but it happens. Demon is having a moment. I'm going to see what my teammate wants to do. Just chill here. What the heck was that? Oh, that was so funny. What the heck? I don't know why that was so funny to me. This is something you don't see in Supersonic Legend. You will not see... you will not see two teammates just, you know, having a bro moment in the middle of the net. That was adorable. We do finish that goal off. He did pass in middle. I don't want to just not score when they give a free pass like that, especially when the opponents are in the corner. I think, you know, those are situations where you should definitely be scoring if you're in my position. I don't want to teach bad habits by not making players push up and stuff. As you can see here, I don't want to go towards the net because they're trying to attack me net side. So what I want to do is just, I want to make sure that I put it around the players. See my teammate can come in and take this ball. Good clear. Good 50-50 as well. Good try. So now the opponent's going to have possession. He's going to take it to the corner. Oh, he's going to default to net. Okay, never mind. So don't do what Fat Moist Dudes just did, which is go into net and just kind of turtle. Sort of what we did earlier as well. You want to make sure you cover all your options. And yeah. Demon did not mean to do that. It's a good try by my teammate too on that shot. But he tried to clear it to the side. Right there, when you see the ball rolling way past the net, just let it go to the corner. There's no need to touch it. I get that maybe you want to pass it to your teammate, but you don't really have to. You can just take the possession from the corner And there we go, another forfeit there. I think I'm doing a little bit too much, moving a little bit too fast. I think I need to slow it down a little bit. But we did get carried by our teammate again, so... You know, honestly, we're not doing a bad job of just chilling and seeing what happens, but I definitely think we need to, you know, make sure we're not going too fast around the field and making those essential touches that you might not be able to at this rank with how much time you've played in the game. But like I said, I'm just trying to reinforce the positioning and the good decisions. You don't want to always go for the ball. And a lot of the times when you have a player on the opposite team on the ball, it's actually a good thing for you because they're going to throw it away most of the time. So just wait for them to do that. And you'll find that you'll have a lot more possession to work with. All right, D's Nuts, the silver tournament winner. Skip Dingle Chuck and Bale Song. A little bit of a bump from our teammate. It's a good shot though. Good save by Bale Song. You can see we're getting up in the ranks. People are starting to get good saves. Take the boost here. Pretty dangerous turn for me, but I don't want to give them possession to be able to take down the field. Although we should be okay with a reactionary shot against a silver player. It's a good try from them again. Bale Song's a little bit confused. Once again, see how the opponent made a touch to throw the ball away. I'm just waiting for them to throw away again. Hit that off the wall. See my teammate can come in. It's a good beat of both players. And there I can hear that Bale Song's coming in. So you see how I make the decision not to try and go for that shot? Just because... there's someone that's going to be beating me if they're going a little bit faster. Clear to the side, let my teammate come in. See what he wants to do here. So just wait, let the ball come into me. See how if I sit further out and scan that field, it's a little bit easier to, you know, to basically have any options available. And as we move up the ranks and move a little bit faster, you have to close that gap. But you see how much space there is on the field. I can just freely bring this to the wall. And then bring it around. We'll see what the opponent does. Good chance for D's Nuts if he can come in and shoot it. Good try. So put it to the corner. See if he wants to touch this. It's okay. Once again, the fake there is really good. Teammate's coming in. Good try by my teammate. Oh, almost on a rule one there. See if he wants to turn on it. It's a good try. Put it to the corner again. Once again, I'm not trying to like reinforce bad habit. Oh, okay. He almost put that in. I'm not trying to miss the ball too often. I mean, aerials, I haven't seen too many players go for aerials yet. So we're just trying to mimic what they're able to do. But I want to make sure that I'm making the right decisions to show you guys, you know, good positioning right here. I want to make sure we move back and save that ball off the corner. It was a bit of a fast reaction. It's pretty dangerous. Could be a good shot from them. Good try by the opponent. Almost getting that shot. Get a block. See if we can... Oh, it was just so funny. I knew it was going to happen too. Like I went for that bump purposely. It's a high clear. It's a good chance here. It's a good shot off to the side, and he gets a demo on me. Hopefully my teammate can rush in and get a clear. He does. This is gonna be really scary for Chalk. This ball will bounce out the corner. If you can see, if I wait here, try to go for the shot. I heard my teammate go, and I want to make sure I don't overcommit, but also that shot was pretty difficult, so I don't want to make a quick shot. The high ball. See if my teammate wants to come in. So see how I want to loop out and let my teammate come in for the next attack. Once again, putting it around the opponent since he's coming towards me. Net side. Both players miss. Good shot. Good try. Oh. Wait, okay. I'm getting a little too advanced. I just realized I was started half-flipping by, like, my natural instincts was to just, like, half-flip and get back. But it's okay. It's a high ball. It's going to go over by the time it gets in front of the net, so you don't have to worry about that. You can drive with the ball here and stay with it. I find that what my teammate's not doing very well is covering the field enough. You see that he's always just hitting the ball away instead of towards a position where he can follow up in the next one. So I'm going to sit here and hit that. It's a good save. So we got these opponents on the other side. have pretty good defense. To the point where I need to like start pressuring a little bit more with shots. See if my teammate can get in there. He's pretty slow to react, but everyone's like pretty consistent with their touches and stuff. As I say that. Good try off the corner. It's gonna go to an overtime here. Good try. So we're depending on our teammate to make a shot here, make a goal, but he's not quite hitting his mark. Makes a shot to the corner. Teammate is not moving. Interesting. Probably upset at himself that he missed that. I kind of knew that he wasn't going to beat the opponent there to that ball. By the way that he did not boost. It's a good try. I'm gonna pop it up. I don't want to score. I don't want to be the one to score this. I'm going to try and get redemption for my teammate, but I just don't know how long that's going to take. Might be here for a while. For as long as it takes, my teammate has to be the one to score here. So let's just let him keep going. I mean, it'd be really funny if we just went for like the longest overtime ever. And that actually brings me to an idea that I have that I want to bring to fruition soon, which is forcing the longest overtime in ranked. But maybe this will be the time here. So to bring it across, it's a good save. Teammate's a little bit lost. Let's see what they want to do here. I'm just gonna sit back, wait for it. It's a good save or a good shot attempt. Good try. Once again, just waiting for D's nuts to pick it up a little bit and see if we can get a goal here. It's a good chance if he can drive into it. Decides to put it behind. See what he does with this. Oh no, this might be in. No, we're okay, we're okay. Okay, we're good. I was gonna try and save it if it was. It's a good try. See if my teammate can come in. So far we're up to 2 minutes in overtime, so let's just see how this goes. Pop it mid. See if my teammate can get ready for the shot. Good try. Oh. Once again, just gonna keep pressuring. Pop it mid. Bit of a pinch. I'm not sure if he wants to touch that, so I'm gonna wait behind and just make sure I don't get cut off by my teammate when he turns there. It's a high ball. It's a little bit spooky. We're should be waiting. Once again, has to be my teammate to score this. So we're gonna pop this middle and see if he can get there. He's a bit far behind. The opponent's coming in. Can he get it? Looks like Bailsong's gonna make the save. So I pop it around them. Now it's my teammate's time to shine. Can he get there? Can he score it? Oh no! All right. Another try. See if he can get on the clear here. He does shoot it downfield. The opponents. Not quite, Okay, that's what I was talking about before, where I don't want my teammate to cut me off like that, and I don't want to overcommit with him when I see him coming towards me. So that's why I wait. That's why you wait there, because you don't want to be overcommitting with your teammate. And we're just going to, once again, just wait for a teammate to call to action here. Pretty tough. He could have actually probably scored that if we didn't hit that. Is that it? Let's go! He redeemed himself. We had to get quite a few saves just because they had a lot of pressure, but great dunk by my teammate. Finally makes a shot on target, and we get the dub. A well-fought game. I think honestly, like, it's fun. I'm not trying to harm anybody. I don't think the opponents are upset by that loss. Like, it was a hard-fought game, and you know, honestly, they probably improved in the long run by playing these games, learning how to deal with like a little bit better positioning and stuff. And they pressured pretty well for Silver 3 players. So that was a good win overall for us. And D's Nuts redeemed himself at the very end. I forgot to mention something, but my name is Do Something with the guy poking with a stick, as requested by you guys. I've been doing this thing in the series so far where the most liked comment about what my Steam name should be and my picture, I will make it my avatar and name as long as it's within TOS. But we're Do Something with a stick this time. Got a teammate who's got a gold tournament winner. So I think we're moving into gold one here. This could be the game where we get it, which would be really nice. But a little bit of overcommit in the corner, an amazing mushroom just coming in and making that clear onto the net. Didn't have to do anything, I've got 2 points, let's go. My teammate got launched really far away. So wait for them to do something in the corner, like I talked about before. Don't want to push too early into the corner. That's when we can challenge. They didn't have a really good control. See my teammate can come in, make it clear. We get bumped by the opponent. Pop up really high. It's going to be really tough for them. So you can see now people are getting like very consistent hits on the ball when they're underneath it. It's going to be a try. A good try. Good try in the pass too. That was smart. He's looking for me. It was a little bit heavy, but still a good try. I'm going to wait for my teammate to make a shot. Almost on target. Put it around them. Keeping good pressure. Okay, good. I was a little pretty worried about that one. I almost pre-jumped or pre-hit that. Put a weight behind my teammate. See what he wants to do. Good shot across. Once again, just waiting in midfield, trying to get this positioning. Make sure I'm covering all my options. He can come down on this, so I gotta be a little bit careful. That's why I wait behind. Pop it out. Dagrin looks pretty confused there. He was underneath the ball. So Mushroom came in and made a good clear. I don't want to take this teammate, my teammate's boost. He ends up not going for it, so now he does. It's a good hit off the wall. He's waiting for me to come in. I just don't know if he wants me to, and I'm not really fully trusting him. He seems to be rotating in pretty good here. But make a good touch. See if I can loop around. Good try. Pop it around again. I should be just scoring those, honestly, at this point. I think players would start clearing it down the field. Make sure you don't throw it away like this. My teammate wants it again. Try to do a balance of proper possession and, playing like a gold, I guess. But you want to make sure you hold on to the ball as much as possible. It's a pretty tough ball, so you let the ball come to you first, then make a touch. Ow. See if Kermit can come and make a save. Good shot from my teammate once again. So he's making the shots to finish it off. I'm not making any of the goals. So I tried to go for 50-50, but I think it was Dagger and he missed the ball. And we end up getting an opening breakaway for my teammate to score. And so far he's had pretty good, what's the word? Oh my. Transition from opportunities to goals. It's a pretty advanced save, but you just gotta get used to the space. 3D space and know when you're underneath the ball to pop that over you. So my teammate gets a shot middle. A little bit of wave dash, just do like a little fancy thing, like a little pop. Teammate is quite single-handedly carrying me here. I'm gonna push in here and try to get in the way. He makes a late touch, which actually made me make a weird touch as well, but it's not a big deal. Good turn there, good patience by my teammate. Pop a middle, see if my teammate goes for it. See, I'm reinforcing that middle pass. A good idea. They're making good saves too. Make a good pop. Should have the save at the back end. Good save by Dagran. Let's go around with full boost. Pops off the wall. A little bit scared my teammate might want to go there. It's a good shot. Oh, so close. So both players are committed into the corner. That's when I can come in and make a touch. Not too scary to deal with. Right there, I would turn, but. Oh, nice try. So I felt like I was doing too much there by turning away and staying with that. Obviously, I would just catch it, but I felt like I was gonna be, you know, too advanced if I just did a drift and turn and stuff. It says what a save. I don't know if that's towards me or towards him, but I guess it was towards himself, which I... Oh, it's not his fault. In reality, I would just save that and just drift and turn with it, but... Making the game close and competitive. It's a good try. Alright, this is a bit advanced, but I should probably chill out a little bit. It's actually good about my teammate, because that goal wouldn't have been deserved at a silver rank or gold rank. And here, see if my teammate can bring it in. It's good patience. Oh, good try. So he had the right idea. He just needs to wait a little bit longer. One guy's not moving, so get over my teammate. Hey, there we go. That's the kind of stuff you want to see. I know I could have shot that, obviously. But when you have the chance, when the ball's pretty tight like this and you don't feel super confident, you can just pass that middle and look how open the net is for him. That's the right thing to go for. Doesn't even say great pass, man. Sad days. But we're 3 seconds left here. What? That was rude. Anyway, GG. I think we're going to make it into gold here, hopefully. We were in silver 3 division 4. Now let's see, did we make it? Oh, we did not make it. So actually, he was a gold tournament winner, but he's silver. So interesting to see that. Hopefully we can get into a gold 3 in this last match here. If not, we'll play one more. And once again, we have an entire lobby of console players. It seems to be so common. Let's see if my team wants to go. He does not want to go, so I'm going to move forward here. I should use some boost and save it so I can stay able to get out of there quickly. It's a good dunk. Teammate bumps me, but wait for his touch. See if he can come in and make a shot. Doesn't have any boost to his name, unfortunately. So if he had a little bit better boost management, he could have chipped around that. See if we can wait for this touch in mid. Just pop that like that and see if my teammate can come in. Nice. Good shot. That's the kind of pressure you want to have. Just go up the wall and make a touch in mid. See what happens. But don't try to chase that yourself, right? So make sure you space out and let your teammate come in. Make that shot. You can reposition behind him. And there we go. First goal up. I'm thinking I can read that this ball is going to bounce here, but my teammate isn't behind me yet, so I want to be a little bit careful to commit. Then I can push in here, make a challenge. Wait behind. Just a little bit lost. Hit it forward. Keeping the ball close. Teammate's a little scared, so I'll move behind him, move a little bit faster. I'm moving pretty quickly, but that's how you can recover so quickly, is just keep that speed up. A little bit of a bump, a little love tap. It's all good. So right here, I want to get mid. Make sure I'm in middle here. I'll try for the shot. Obviously, I don't want to, like, score that, but I'm going to try with my teammate. So close. Good shot by, or good save by them. Clear to the corner now. My teammate wants the corner boost, so I'm going to loop wide. Someone should be challenging this, which is good that he's moving up. Good patience for him to leave that for me, too. Good trust. So I have 100 boost. Just going to wait on the side here. Wait for him to make a touch. So yeah, just wait in mid. That way I can cover all those options. Good challenge. I don't have to do too much. That's the key, right? Don't try to do too much. The teammates or the players who try to overcomplicate everything are the ones that are going to struggle a lot to rank up, because it's just less is more sometimes. Not trying to overwhelm the opponents. I'm just trying to position well for my teammate. Make sure he's covered. I don't know what he wants to do here, so I'm just going to let him keep reversing and see what happens here. So right here, I can loop wide. I probably would stay with this ball, but I feel okay to loop wide here. It's pretty dangerous, though. It's a good shot attempt. Good for my teammate to loop back. He said thanks because he actually hit that towards me. So here, I'll quickly loop back, get in position. Go for the pass middle. Teammate wants to rush in. That's okay. It's a good pop from them. Once again, loop out wide. Teammate can come in. Goes behind him. Then I can become the new player to get that challenge. You can see as we move down up the ranks, we're starting to get more of a trade-off in rotation, which is really good. Kind of reflecting that. My teammate is in a weird spot, so I want to turn back and get that challenge. Get behind, let him come in first. Good trade-off of rotation. It's always funny to me just to miss those when they're so free, but I don't want to like overwhelm them once again, like I said. So right here, the ball's pretty high. I'll flick it like this once the ball's above my car. Come behind, maybe my teammate wants to push in. There we go. There we go, great pass. Once again, those are opportunities that are completely open, so I should definitely score those when my teammate makes a perfect pass off the corner. That's well within your capabilities. If you just sit in training like I talked about in the first few episodes and just work on your striker training, that should be enough for you to practice just shooting those open nets. There's so many different training packs you can pick from. You can even make your own and just make sure you get good contact on the ball. But it looks like we just made it into gold one, which is perfect. Perfect end of this episode. We get gold one division two. So I hope you guys enjoy this 10th episode of the Supersonic Legend series. It's been quite fun to record so far. Like I said, let me know what you guys want my name and title or name and picture to be for the next episode. But until next time, hope you guys have a great day. We'll catch you guys in the next one.